today we're going to be going over this possible named winter storm. This is actually the low pressure system for the severe weather risk today. But here comes another system. There's a line of ice that goes through before the heavy, very heavy snow goes through Indiana, Ohio, Illinois, Michigan, and even western Pennsylvania. It kind of just sits there and brings you possible snow for a very long period of time in Ohio, Indiana, and Illinois. Almost a few days of times of snow could be expected from the system. Snow, ice, sleet, even some rain, you name it, is all in the system. For more areas like in New York City, it is more on the thunderstorm side. Now here is the snow accumulated snowfall, and as you can see, it gets fairly high, up to 15 inches. But with all this system combined, lasting like bringing you rounds of snow day by day, almost every day. In fact, for 3 days, you are going to be seeing periods of snow, and the snow could accumulate to 1 to 2 feet at times in some areas in total, because the high temperatures are right around 3 feet in some areas. So a few feet of snow should be expected because there's multiple rounds from this. Now here is one of the bigger times of the storm. Northwestern Pennsylvania, 3 inches. North Central Ohio, 10 inches. 8 inches in Columbus, 8.7 inches, and then a 20 inch in northwestern Ohio. Disclaimer, the regions that have potentially more than 2 feet of snow are actually areas with lake effect snow combining in the time range of this system. Here's my snowfall amount forecast from this four-day system. So here's the temperature anomalies. 72 hours ago, most of the warm air, it was mostly warm air, cool air take over briefly, then the warm air comes back in and is continuing over the next, let's say, 24 hours, and maybe a little bit longer than that, maybe a few days. Then the cool air briefly comes in, warm air briefly comes in, then here is the big blast of cold air. Almost 10 to 15 degrees below average with this snowstorm. There isn't much in the way of freezing rain in this system. Maybe upstate New York will have some, Vermont, Maine will have some from this, but not really much. But one thing that's similar to freezing rain, I have to tell you, is that in the upper levels of the atmosphere, it's below freezing. Then, between the ground and the upper atmosphere, it is above freezing. Then, near the ground, it is below, just below freezing. So, this could be an issue. Here's why. This system is going to have a mixture of rain, sleet, and snow, mostly. Some ice. But most of the rain that falls is going to, at the surface, freeze, and that is going to make the road slippery. So try to be careful when driving and taking a walk. And then, here's a big issue, it's going to freeze even on branches. So those branches could fall, and it could make damage to trees, and it could fall on power lines. And it could, when it falls on power lines, damage the power lines. It could even fall on homes. Then the icicles could wear down those power lines and break them. And that is actually quite an issue because it really can do a lot of damage. So I advise you to take precautions with this system. And also, the ice is going to make, usually you don't see snow accumulating on gravel this early on roads, but it actually will, because the ice will be sticking for a while and then the snow will be able to accumulate on that cold surface. So this also will help the snow pile up. At the surface, we have some very cold, well, somewhat cold temperatures in the 20s and 30s, And even in upper elevations in far northern part of the U.S. and far northern part of the system, there could even be teens. As you can see here, temperatures in the system are probably 10 to 15 degrees below average. Bye, thanks for watching. Make sure to like if you liked this weather-related content. Share it with anybody who could be impacted by this storm. Subscribe if you like my weather-related content. And why not throw a comment down below?